The first storm to hit the Philippines this year leaves a trail of death and destruction over the weekend. Disaster management officials are still validating at least 5 casualties linked to Typhoon Aghon. Rafael Bozano has tonight's top story.
Typhoon Aghon's winds drove this barge into the dock. Residents are thankful it did not hit their homes. Many have started to clean up after flood waters subsided. The storm also damaged several boats. One Bayan patroller took a video of the fallen trees that litter the streets of Polillo, also in Quezon. The local government says nearly 500 families in more than a dozen villages are still staying in at least 3 evacuation centers. It also plans to permanently relocate residents living near riverbanks.
Yung mga tao talaga hindi natututo in times of calamity. Yun talaga. Kasi supposed to be naka-early ang aming pre-disaster, nakapag-advise na pumunta sa mga evacuation centers. Kaya yun ang naging problema namin.
In Calabarzon, the Philippine National Police has recorded 3 fatalities.
Ang patay po ay 3. At dyan po ay sa Calabarzon na ang 3 po dyan, yung bata po, yung 7-month-old na namatay po sa pagkalunod. Yung isa naman po ay namatay dahil nabagsakan po ng puno, at yung isa naman po ay ganun din po, nabagsakan din po ng puno po. Dyan po yan lahat sa Calabarzon po, itong 3 po.
Residents in the town of Baí in the province of Laguna continue to reel from Aghon's devastating effects. One resident says the extreme heat the past few months made her pray for rain, but she didn't expect it to be this bad.
Eh, yung mga manugang ko nga nagtatawa sa akin, gasawi sa akin, hiling kayo ng hiling, pinagbigyan kayo, nagre-reklamo naman kayo.
Almost 400 families in Baí remain in evacuation centers following the flood. The local government says floods happen every year because of the town's low elevation. With more frequent rain that will most likely be followed by the wet La Nina, preparation to prevent damage and death is key.
Disaster response preparedness po natin, and then yung camp management, yun po yung paspapaitingin pa. Yung aming bayan po talaga ay kapag umulan lang ay konting ulan ay tumataas.
In the province of Pampanga, despite the absence of a tropical cyclone wind signal, gloomy weather with occasional showers persisted, resulting in flooding in some villages. Over in Bicol, more than 6,000 families from 37 villages were affected by heavy rains over the weekend. According to the region's Office of Civil Defense, 7 individuals sustained injuries. Latest reports also show that over 100 passengers remain stranded in Camarines Norte and Pasacao Port in Camarines Sur. Typhoon Aghon destroyed 4 homes and partially damaged 18 others in eastern Visayas, according to the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office. 1.9 million pesos worth of assistance has been given by the OCD and the Social Welfare Department to Mimaropa and Bicol regions. State Weather Bureau Pagasa has earlier said that future typhoons may be stronger and devastating, something that no longer comes as a surprise because of climate change. But this is also something that local governments must prepare for to avoid much dreaded death and destruction. Rafael Bozano, ABS-CBN News, Baí, Laguna.